I am a professor especially. So the profile is we have, I am faculty here at the Department of Management Studies, IIT Delhi. So I am professor of operations management and I take care of courses like supply chain management, operations management, manufacturing studies. And manufacturing is one of my core disciplines. And I worked as a, in a lab at National University of Singapore, which is in the collaboration with MIT USA. And when I did some work on the manufacturing only. So this is what are the various courses which I do here for the last more than 10 years.
Okay, wonderful. So we recently heard about a news which talked about, which mentioned, you know, how IIT Delhi and you as a professor along with your team have come up with an idea or a concept which will help in, you know, achieving this central government's initiative of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Can you throw a little more light about the whole intent or the focus of that particular initiative?
Yeah, sure. It's a very valid actually question nowadays because and we do agree with the central government's this philosophy of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Unless we are self-reliant, we cannot actually do anything for the nation. And IIT Delhi is always committed towards developing anything which is good for the nation. In this context, I started working on Industry 4.0 through my research scholar. So we, supervise PhDs. So where we can do research in the latest topics. So Industry 4.0 is one of the latest trend in the manufacturing sectors, especially where people are talking about creating a very accurate and precise manufacturing of the products as per the need of the market. So what happens, this is a very latest technology in manufacturing, appeared from one of the European country in 2010 or 11. So we started thinking how Industry 4.0 actually can be implemented in the Indian manufacturing industry. For that we started working for the last I think more than 4 years. And here we got that there is a study is required to actually tell how the Industry 4.0 setup can be implemented in a manufacturing sector, especially in the Indian manufacturing sector. Okay. So what we did, we studied a good amount of literature on it and tried to think that what actually Industry 4.0 talks about. So Industry 4.0 is basically a concept where high technology, IoT based, cyber physical system based, shop floor is converted into the this kind of setup, and where less human intervention is required, where the data is transmitted through RFID or sensor based, and the manufacturing can be done very precisely and accurately.
Okay.
So, but there was no mathematical model actually developed to really understand how much saving in the terms of production cost, how much of saving in the terms of manufacturing cost can be actually achieved through the Industry 4.0. Even though in literature we studied, we saw most of the work was on the framework, theoretical framework or empirical framework, which parameter is very important and why it is important, such kind of studies available. But mathematically, there was no such model which can actually tell very precisely that how much saving we can do. And since today we are in the situation where environment is one of the major concerns. Any manufacturing we do, and if it is hampering our environment, so that actually is not a good for the coming generation, because we have to save the environment. So we also take into account that how the manufacturing through Industry 4.0 can actually consider the environmental factor. So what we did in this mathematical model, which we recently published in one of the top journals, and says that we considered various cost, which is very important for the organization, especially manufacturing organization, and what are the various cost parameter which can be which has to be there in the Industry 4.0. So we consider all the cost parameter and we develop a model, and that model comes out to be a very complex model, and to show that really the models will work or not, mathematical model will work or not, then we gather the data in the form of various parameters such as installation cost, calibration cost, transmission cost, carbon emission cost into the environment, mm-hmm. and all these various cost parameter we obtained, then we also got the information what could be the demand in the market of this product. So we assume this kind of thing, mm-hmm. that there is a demand in the market for this mm-hmm. product, and this product has to be made for a multiple period, for mm-hmm. 1 year, maybe more than 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, and how to meet the demand with a low manufacturing cost. Then we fit all this information into the model, and then model was executed for more than I think 1 week,
okay.
continuously on the this our system, and we found that, and we repeated this experiment I think more than 20-30 times we repeated, just to get really there is any, you know, saving in the terms of cost or not. Once we got the result, then we did the comparative analysis that if we don't consider the industry 4.0, what will happen to the production. In that case, we saw that there was a too much of production cost involved.
Okay.
And once we apply a industry 4.0 concept,
mm-hmm.
We saw that there is a saving in the cost. So we said that through the industry 4.0, you know, philosophy, actually we can make a low cost, environmentally sustainable production, and we can save too much of cost, and in long run it can be very beneficial to the, you know, manufacturing industry. So this is all about, you know, simple terms, that what this model is all about.
Great, wonderful, Professor Singh. So my next question, related to the same project that you are talking about, is that you talked about 20-30, you know, use cases in terms of testing this, the mathematical model around it.
Yes.
So are these, were these use cases related to IIT campus only, limited to, or also the commercial or the, you know, actual manufacturer of a particular thing?
Okay, so it's a very interesting question. So what happens, Jogesh ji, so what we initially tried, we contacted one of few industries to get the data.
Okay.
So unfortunately, we could not get the data, the kind of the data which the mathematical model required to them.
Mm-hmm.
So we simulate the model.
Okay.
We generated the similar data using some simulation program, and we got this data, and we realized that these data are follow the same characteristics which we generally see in the manufacturing. So if I say simple terms, like if I do the production for 1 hour, so what is the amount of carbon will emit into the environment? So we get this data and we generate this data for a bigger size of the problem randomly using some kind of random function in the system, and then we tested it. So
okay.
This testing has been done with a various kind of the data. Various
okay.
kind of data. When I see that one set of data, then the same model is run for the second set of data, third set of data. So what we did, we actually run for the more than 20-30 different types of the data.
Okay.
Then we finally concluded that this mathematical model says that ki we have to go towards industry 4.0 setup. This is the future actually. And every industry should try to minimize the cost. But how to minimize the cost? So the model tells you that how much to produce, where to produce, and what kind of machine is required, and so that you can meet the demand, and at the same time you can also save the time,
okay.
save the cost, because cost and time is very important for the industry.
Absolutely.
So that is why, and at the same time we can also save the environment.
Thank you, sir, on sharing these wonderful thoughts about this program initiative. Next question is related to something which is happening worldwide.
Okay.
And that thing is not a good one.
Okay, so
which is, I'm sure you must be okay. also be seeing, or you know, are a part of it directly or indirectly. So can you elaborate, or how has your, you know, professional life got impacted, or let's say affected or benefited out of it?
So I think if I guessing correctly, so you're referring to the, you know, current pandemic.
Absolutely.
Okay. So pandemic has given, you know, some kind of definitely a very big jolt to the economy, the entire economy of the world, but especially in the Indian economy, we have seen a lot of, you know, issues. But this has also given a, you know, some direction that we have to stand and we have to go towards self-reliant. We cannot depend our country cannot depend every time for the from the outside. So we have to stand together, and I agree with the, you know, India's current government mission that we have to go for Atmanirbhar. Unless we adopt a new technology, unless we do the work for our country, we know them. We have the capability. The country has enough resources, enough capability that we can go in that direction.
Okay.
So this pandemic has given a push that this time has come that we have to go. And I must say that the current government, Modi's government, that when we say digital India, make in India, so this cannot happen without boosting the manufacturing sector. So Industry 4.0, that is the one objective of this research, that Industry 4.0 pave the way to implement the India's vision of, you know, make in India, make and in then India. Definitely Atmanirbhar Bharat.
Wonderfully stated, sir. Now, my last question, I believe, will be, where do you see your project down the line, let's say 3 to 5 years from now?
So what I have planned after this, definitely I will approach to some of the industries,
mm-hmm.
and I will talk to that, please make a paradigm shift from traditional way of manufacturing to the, you know, advanced way of manufacturing, that is Industry 4.2.
Okay.
So I hope that we can secure some kind of funding where more work can be done, and we can actually show on the real ground that how the traditional manufacturing can be converted to the, you know, very advanced manufacturing. Either you talk about 3D printing or additive manufacturing. So unless we actually show the benefits to the manufacturing industry, definitely they will also not come. So my next, you know, approach would be to contact few industries where we can speak about this kind of mathematical model, their findings and their outcomes, and we can request that let us work on this and see what is the benefit in the terms of you know, saving the economy, saving the environment, and without, you know, without compromising on the quality.
Okay.
Yeah.
So again, a leading question from this last question, which has come up to my mind, is manufacturing companies, right? And which means Industry 4.0 will play a big role, especially in the manufacturing sector.
Correct.
So within the manufacturing sector, there are a lot of, you know, bifurcations if we talk about like SME, MSME. So is there any particular segment within the manufacturing sector where this initiative will be better than the other ones?
So initially we thought of going with the automobile sector,
mm-hmm.
but it can be implemented to the cement industry, textile industry, any manufacturing industry where actually the physical products are being made, where the raw material is being transported from the vendors, where the processing is being done inside in-house the manufacturing. So this thing can be implemented. But initially, just to start up, we will approach some automobile industry, maybe the spare part automobile manufacturing industry.
So
it could be
automobile is one. Other than automobile, any other?
Cement industry
is one.
Steel industries.
Steel industry.
Textile industries. Even pharmaceutical industries. This could be.
Pharmaceutical.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
How about chemicals, petrochemicals, oil and gas?
Yeah, it could be. Definitely, I don't have right idea, but definitely it could be, because these are also manufacturing this.
Because a bit too small, MSME, if you talk about, these are the areas where, you know, these guys play a big role, which is automobile, steel, cement. Unlike oil and gas or a chemical where, you know, a lot of precision kind of.
Yeah, they're very big manufacturing actually.
Those require a huge investments, right?
Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Mr. Professor Dr. S.P. Singh, for speaking with DG Analysis.
So thank you, Yogesh.
We wish you and your team all the best.
Thank you very
and
much.
Happy New Year from all of us.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks. Bye.